Would you bow your head with us? Our gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you that you've given us an opportunity to gather once again. Lord, your scripture tells us that we are to take the first tenth of everything that we are blessed with and continue to pass that on and give that back to you. So, Father, we take this opportunity to once again do what you've called us to do. We ask your blessing on this offering. We ask your wisdom for those who steward these resources, that they choose what to do with them, and that you move through this offering mightily through this town, through this valley, and through this ministry. So, Lord, bless the gift and bless the giver. We'll be careful to thank you for all these things in the name of your Son, Jesus. And all God's people said,
amen.
Amen.
And now, your co-hosts, Corey Gallardo and Dylan Little.
Thank you so much for this award. I am so honored to be here to receive this award. I have so many people that I'd like to thank, and I'll just start with, it's been such an honor to just be nominated for award.
What do you think you won?
I didn't win anything.
Oh man, this is a little awkward. No, Corey, we're just the hosts. Yeah.
We're the hosts.
Yeah.
Well, even though I thought I was here for more than just hosting this shindig, it's still pretty exciting. I mean, Look, there's balloons and statues and stars.
Oh, God.
Thought I was the big winner, I can make a little bit of an attitude adjustment and we can start over.
All right. Anyways,
welcome to our morning at the Oscars.
We deserve it. We're really, really good.
I can see why I was asked to host this event. Okay. Again, the spotlights, The stars.
Oh, God, come on.
But you, as the co-host, the one who dressed like a girl and flipped his hair at the pie auction. This should be interesting.
Y'all see how much we raised? That was like $12,000 for that hair flip, okay? That hair flip is what got us to Mexico, okay? So I personally think we flip the hair every year.
Seriously, Pastor Appreciation Day is one that we love.
Yeah, well, each one of these guys don't.
We have a great time, full of laughs.
But it's all at their expense.
And you get to know your pastors a little bit better.
Okay.
So we thought, what could we do this year?
Well, there's always a baseball theme.
Done that.
Oh. Okay, well, how about a mini service by kids?
Been there.
Okay, this is awkward. We can roast them?
Don't you ever come to church?
I thought I did, but apparently not. But then I thought, hey, you know, we're dressed nice somewhat, and we can always do like an Oscars, right?
Well, then let's do the Oscars, and let's get this party started with the song that captivates the essence of these six men. Here's Bob Bergfeld and Tammy Allen. We thought we would spin a twist on our Oscar categories and have some fun with them.
So not only will we be presenting the Oscars, but I'll also be tying in the Fruits of the Spirit as well.
Our first category is for Best Documentary. Best Documentary covers Best Feature and Best Short Subject Films. As the counseling pastor here at New Hope, Rich Smith could be best known for his own short stories, sequels, love stories, drama, or action-packed thrillers.
All right. The names have been changed to protect the innocent.
Rich, you have always been such a quiet leader, yet your counseling style speaks volumes. Thank you. The winner for Best Documentary goes to Rich Smith.
Cool. Revelation 14:12 says, "Meanwhile, the saints stand passionately patient, keeping God's command and staying with them faithful to Jesus."
Romans 8:25, "But if we hope for what is still unseen by us, we wait for it with patience and composure." Romans 12:12, "Rejoice in hope, be patient in tribulation, and constant in prayer."
Rich, we want to thank you for all your patience and using God's gift the way that you do. We also want to thank you for your commitment to Ashbrook and New Hope Community Church. So with that, the Spirit for the Spirit Award for patience goes to
Rich Smith.
At this time, if you'd like to say a couple comments to family, friends, we would greatly like that.
I don't know what to say. I'm overwhelmed. I appreciate the sentiment. I think I could speak for all the guys that will be coming up that there really is only one person to be honored, and that is the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And that he is the reason that we have hope, the reason that we have life, the reason that we have this capacity to come together today. And so it's to him that we give all honor and glory and thanksgiving. But I certainly do appreciate the opportunity that I've had to be involved in ministry here at New Hope. I do want to make a small correction to the announcement. I'm not really the leader of the small group ministries. That award actually should go to Corey. She and Teddy are the leaders of small group. I'm just a corporal in that army. But I do lead the adult Bible study, or Sunday school Bible study, and we've recently been studying the books of 1st and 2nd Peter, and I'd like to invite you to join. 1st and 2nd Peter are wonderful books. Both talk about the challenges that the churches face from without and challenges from within, and those challenges are still valid today. And so we'd like to have you come and join us at 9:15 if you want to do that. Thank you.
Thanks, Rich. Impressive. Our next award is for Best Music. For achievements in music written for motion picture, for score, song, and musical. It's no surprise or best kept secret that Associate Pastor Gene Sperling has one of the finest voices around. Gene's funny wit and personality often come out when he's singing a ZZ Top tune. Yes, ZZ.
Hang on. I think since his name's Gene, we do more of a Jeansy top? Yeah. Actually, you know, hang on, Randy. I think this is a more of a DMX feel type atmosphere. So it's like, Lord, give me a sign. I really need to talk to you, Lord. Since the last time we talked, the walk has been hard. Now I know you haven't left me, but I feel like I'm alone. I'm a big boy now, but I'm still not grown. Devil, I rebuke you. What you make me go through? I can see you trying to do what I used to, but all that stops right here, because as long as the Lord's in my life,
okay,
I will have
no fear. Okay, enough. Enough.
Hey, Gene. That was impressive. We'll work together later, okay? We'll get something going.
And the Oscar for Best Music goes to Gene Sperling.
Like a cross between Rudy Valley and Pee Wee Herman.
Right? I do what I can.
Is that funny wit of Gene's?
Anyways, Hebrews 11:1 says, "Now faith is the assurance of things hoped for and the conviction of things not seen." Matthew 25:21 also says, "Well done, good and faithful servant."
Proverbs 28:20, "A faithful man will abound with blessings." Luke 16:10, One who is faithful in very little is also faithful in much. Gene, as we read each one of these scripture verses on faithfulness, we see your name is next to each.
Gene, I want to thank you, especially for what you do for all the seniors and the man that you do, and for always lending a hand and making jokes when I'm on stage trying to do my skit. I really appreciate it. But anyways, I do want to thank you for being the supportive role for the associate pastor. So, with that being said, the Fruit of the Spirit Award for faithfulness goes to...
Gene Sperling!
Cool. Gene, if you'd like to say something.
Am I done now?
No, if you'd like to say something, this is your time. This is your time.
Oh, well, if someone were to ask me, what do you do? I said, well, I get to study the Bible and teach it. I mean, is there anything better than that?
Amen.
Gee, incredible. Being here at New Hope has been a great experience for me to be able to return to the calling that God gave me years ago that I ignored for 35 years and go into ministry again on a professional basis. It's allowed me to work with discipleship through Operation Timothy and other programs. It's a wonderful thing to meet one-on-one with another man and go through the subjects of the Bible, to work with the wonderful seniors that we have in this church, to visit them, along with Jerry, my wife, and to spend time with them and honor them. They are indeed wonderful, wonderful, precious folk. And just a host of other opportunities that are presented. The church is responsible for my wife and I finding a husband for our daughter. And for that we are ever grateful. But it's a delight to serve the Lord and to see him work.
Amen. Estamos aquí para presentar el próximo premio a la mejor película extranjera o un tipo que conoce a todos los países sobre extranjeros, nuestra misión, Pastor Gil Hernández.
Corey, what was that?
My clearly polished Spanish, right?
Okay, this is awkward. Can I get a translator to translate what she just said? Because to me it sounded like aquí.
Well, then let's try this again, even though I think I did a pretty good job. Yeah. Our next award is for Best Foreign Film. This represents the best foreign language film, foreign films from Russia, Colombia, Pacific Island, and Africa, to name a few. Gil could write. Gil's heart for Mexico and his love for missions globally are amazing. For many years, Gil has attended our youth missions trip. Gil, to date, is still a very active interpreter for many organizations in the United States. The Oscar for Best Foreign Film goes to Gil Hernandez.
Proverbs 19:22. What is desirable in a person is kindness. Proverbs 3:3, never let loyalty and kindness leave you. Tie them around your neck as a reminder. Write them down deep within your heart.
Philemon 1:7, your love has given me much joy and comfort, my brother, for your kindness has often refreshed the hearts of God's people. Gil, we are so grateful for your kindness that you bestow on others through a handshake, a hug, a smile, and a helping hand. Thank you for being the man of God you are. Thank you for carrying our missions outreach for so many years and the constant communication that you keep with many missionaries in other countries.
So, with that being said, the Fruit of the Spirit Award for kindness goes to, oh, would you look at that?
Gil Hernandez.
Your turn, Gil. Get to say something.
How do you follow that? As a young man, growing up in the city of Chicago, attending a little mission in the near north side of Chicago, I came to know the Lord Jesus Christ as my personal Savior at age 14. At age 18, I was baptized at the same little mission, and it's just been a blessing in my life to know the Lord Jesus Christ since then. My favorite verse from the scriptures is Matthew 6:33. I believe that was possibly one of the first verses I memorized as a young man. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. They've really been added. Added so much so that I sit back and wonder, when does a person my age stop working? Stop doing things? Well, as long as the Lord gives me strength, I will continue to do what he's asked me to do. I do go down to Mexico. In fact, we're already talking about going down to Mexico in December again for Jaron Bible Institute that begins in January for a couple weeks. And I look forward to going back down there because that's where my first wife and I started. That's where I met Angelina, my present wife, 49 years ago. And it just seemed that the Lord brought us together, she as a widow and I as a widower. And I'm so thankful for Angelina that the Lord has really blessed me with her, and I thank her. When does a person stop? We as Christians don't stop. And I was talking to her recently as to my age. January, I'll hit the big 80, the big 80. And she encouraged me by saying, "You don't even look 75 yet." So I'm so thankful that we can continue to be here at New Hope Community Church. This has been our home church since 1985. Well, not New Hope, but Ashbrook combined with New Hope. And we're certainly thankful for all of you who pray for us. It's been a blessing to be able to serve you in the missions department. And it's just, I'm getting antsy to go down to Columbia and go see the Actus. So whenever that comes about, let me know and we'll be working on that. I do know that there is a group going down this year, and I'm thinking about that very seriously. So the Lord bless you all, and we pray that you will continue to remember those of us who serve you. Notice the word I said, serve you. And as the song was sung a little while ago, I recall the words of the written words of Major Ian Thomas, that the Lord Jesus Christ, God the Father, the Holy Spirit, made man in his own image. And he goes on to state that those who see us in the image of God should reflect who God is. I pray and trust that that's what we are all doing here at New Hope.
Amen. Thank you, Gil. Our next award is for Animated Film of the Year. As with any animated movie, we find ourselves transforming into character and living the character in the movie. Just like when I first watched Mary Poppins. And I just decided that I must always speak in an English accent and say, "Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in it the most delightful way."
You done?
Most certain that I could forever and fly with an umbrella to help young people everywhere, but alas, I couldn't. And in the exact same way, our youth pastor, Robert Hutchinson, has the uncanny ability to change into character and transform into whatever he needs for any occasion. From preaching on a Sunday to eating worms, snakes, or crickets on trips with the guys, Robert's animated love for life shows through. The Oscar for Best Animated Film goes to Robert Hutchinson.
Thank you.
I knew you always wanted one of those.
You know, I said the music fits you, right? Clowny? That was chosen for you.
We're going to switch to the roast again, if you don't mind.
Robert, no, I'm kidding. 1 Timothy 6:11. But you, man of God, flee from all this and pursue righteousness, godliness, faith, love, endurance, and gentleness. Proverbs 15:1. A gentle answer turns away wrath.
Philippians 4:5. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Ephesians 4:2. Be completely humble and gentle. Be patient, bearing with one another in love. Sorry.
Robert, I want to thank you from me personally for dealing with me, being so patient. It isn't easy. With your desire, with all the missions and youth missions, is uncanny, and how long you've been doing this is truly remarkable. Because I know we're not easy to deal with. So may your very gentle spirit remain full of spirit always. And with that, I say that for the spirit for gentleness goes to
Melissa Hutchinson.
I'm sorry, we Melissa.
We wanted to give her patience, but it was already taken. So we decided we'd go with gentleness.
If you can't have fun,
we'll give you gentleness. Yeah. Robert Hutchinson.
All right, Robert Hutchinson. Oh, you can speak now. This is your time.
I don't think anybody's ever accused me of being speechless before. How many know that that pastors are broken people too? I was broken as a youth when this church brought our family food and presents on Christmas because we couldn't afford them. And New Hope showed me what hope looks like. And I decided then, though I thought I would never be good enough, that I would spend my life trying to pass out hope like it was candy in my pocket. Because someone did that for me. But then I spent my young adult life running from that. And pastors are broken people too. Having kids and getting back into the Word of God and rededicating that first hope I was given. And I'm still learning things. I'm learning not to judge. And I love the opportunity to just give out of brokenness. How many know that behind every youth pastor who thinks he's awesome, there's a staff rolling their eyes? One of those that keep me on my toes is Brittany Luttrell, who shared with me not too long ago the analogy of the bell sheep. And I guess the bell sheep is, in a flock of sheep, there's a particular sheep who isn't all that great, honestly. It's not unblemished, but it happens to love the shepherd and know the shepherd's voice. And so the shepherd will tie a bell around the sheep's neck. And the rest of the sheep don't necessarily want to be around the shepherd. but they want to be together. And so wherever the bell sheep goes, they can hear that bell chiming, and the other sheep will follow. So Brittany says to me, you know, Robert, you're not all that great.
Sounds like her.
You're just a bell sheep. And I thought, you know what? I like that better. Because then we're just together, and we're doing this life together. And I thank you for allowing me to be a part of the life that you're living.
Amen. Thank you, Robert.
Thank you, sheep.
The award for best director is given to a person who directs and leads. The definition is one who interprets the script and supervises the development of a theater, film, television, or radio production. May I suggest that it is a person who interprets the Word of God, presents the Bible as script for our lives, and supervises the development of the flock in which God has given him to shepherd. Our senior pastor, Tim Rowland, is our director. I'm thankful for his direction, guidance, and a helping hand at changing my personal script. He is one who will always give honor to a life and applaud the final take from this life to home. The Oscar for Best Director goes to Pastor Tim Rowland.
See if you guys are standing for me. Okay. So Romans 15:13 says, "May the God of hope fill you with all the joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope and the power of the Holy Spirit." Psalms 28:7, "The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusts in him and I am helped. My heart leaps for joy and I will give thanks to him in song."
1 Peter 1:8-9, "Though you have not seen him, you love him. And even though you do not see him now, you believe in him and are filled with an inexpressible and glorious joy, for you are receiving the goal of your faith, the salvation of your souls." Hebrews 12:2, "Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God." Pastor Tim, we as a church are grateful for your unselfish leadership, your tireless giving, and your ongoing belief in each of us. Thank you for demonstrating the unspeakable joy you preach about.
And the Fruit of the Spirit Award for joy goes to...
Who could it be?
I don't like that answer.
Tim Rowland!
I always thought directors were supposed to be in charge. I had nothing to do with today. For those of you who don't know, all of my fellow workers together in ministry here hate this day. It makes us very uncomfortable, though we deeply appreciate your kind generosity and expressions. I've had a very blessed life. I was blessed with incredible parents. I was blessed with incredible grandparents. I had some of the greatest friends and mentors as a child, as a teen, and as a young adult. And in spite of all of those incredible blessings, what Robert said is absolutely correct about all of us, and that is, all of us are flawed. We're all broken. Whether we come from great family backgrounds or whether we come from difficult and strained and challenged family backgrounds, we're all flawed. If we come from a place of blessing, we think that we, if we're not careful, we think that we deserve more than we get. If we come from a broken background, we think we ought to get more than we get. And if we're not careful, we both end up in the same place, being very selfish. And that's the common brokenness that all of us experience, is selfishness. And a selfish person can never have this fruit of the Spirit called joy, because there's never enough to satisfy us. And so the fruit of the Spirit of joy is only made possible in us when, as Gil stated, we come to the end of ourselves and we understand that fullness, restoration, healing, moving from brokenness to recovery is possible when Jesus Christ lives and reigns through us. And it is a privilege to prepare, to share, to preach, to counsel, to stay up all night, whatever it takes to try to make a connection with a young person, a young adult, a senior, someone in midlife, computers that talk, somehow trying to make a connection that Jesus Christ can make all the difference. So thank you for the privilege of, between Ashbrook and New Hope, of serving my entire ministry in just one place. You deserve an award. So thank you very much for the privilege.
Stay. Our last category of the morning is our Lifetime Achievement Award. The Lifetime Achievement Award is presented to an individual who has dedicated his or her life, to making things better, to taking them to the next level, or helping them see an upper story perspective. And here to present this award is Senior Pastor Tim Rowland.
It's the truth. I really had no idea what today was all about. I only found out this morning that I was going to be presenting this award. I want to read to you an email that was received about my dad, Lonnie Rowland. It came from an old friend who didn't have the ability to get it on video, or we would be seeing it on the big screen. So, Dad, I want you to come on up and have a seat on this stool. Here's the letter that was received, and these are the things that were written. I met Lonnie Rowland in July 1969 in Fresno, California. I was 24 years old. I had just been appointed the academic dean of California Christian College. Lonnie was already a highly respected leader in California and in the broader Free Will Baptist denomination. Lonnie was an encourager to young preachers and workers. He led by his tireless example. He was always first in line when there was work to do at the church or the college or the local association or the state meetings. Lonnie and his wife June made an amazing team. They each had their own special kind of leadership, their own unique gifts, and they used them to boost and care for each other. June, she was a superstar in women's outreach. Lonnie, you were her most active cheerleader. You were never jealous as she rose to national prominence in women's work. Lonnie was also one of the most generous men with his pulpit that I've ever known. He welcomed others to preach regularly. I preached in his church many times during regular Sunday services, special events, and even more. Lonnie made me a member of his family. He shared his family with us all, opening his home, and most of all, his heart. Lonnie was a quiet hero in turbulent times. He maintained his balance even when others fell victim to the clamor and the chatter of the flower child culture of the 1960s and the 70s. Lonnie rescued men from the bitterness of alcoholism, and the most notable being our mutual friend, Gene Fry. Lonnie trusted me with his wife and his daughter and his son. He trusted me with his secrets, and I felt like a king when I was in his presence. He deserved much more credit than he ever received, but he was always eager to give credit to others. If I ever grow up, I'd like to be a man of honor like Lonnie Rowland. He's my hero, and I love him far more than he ever knows. Lonnie loved others. It showed in his home. It showed at his church. It showed at the cotton gin. It showed when he drove on the highway, not like his son. It showed at church conferences and everywhere he was. I've never known a man who took less from life, but who gave royally. What a friend, what a preacher, what a great husband, father, and pastor. I salute Lonnie Rowland, the man who led quietly and biblically and, of course, honestly. Lonnie Rowland was a thoroughbred champion surrounded by colorful show ponies who clamored for the headlines. Lonnie asked for nothing except for a chance to work and to love, and he did it all. Jack Williams, your friend and mine.
Speeches, not much on being out in front as far as leadership anymore, but I do love the Lord with all my heart. I love this people. I love this church. I love Jesus most of all, for he gave his life that I could have life and have it more abundantly. I never was a great preacher as far as being a preacher, but I had to love for people that I'd be able to help them and give them the courage and strength to go forward and serve the Lord as their personal Savior. A lot of things I don't know, but this one thing I do know. He says, I am the life, I'm the way, and I'm the truth. And it's the only way is through Jesus Christ. And I don't like to bring things up like this, but many of you don't know that I was paralyzed when this young man was born from the waist out. But God saw fit that I would be able to see him grow up. And I'm thankful for what he's doing for the Lord, that I had a hand in being able to point him to the Lord Jesus Christ, and he accepted, and he's doing a great work, I think, for the Lord.
I didn't hand you the microphone yet because it wasn't your turn to talk.
Yeah, it's all right.
But it's okay. At 88, you get to call the shots. Okay? I have the privilege of calling him Dad. And my dad is not a complicated man. He's simple. Actually, scroll that back. You jumped ahead too fast for me. He is so simple. That his primary things are being interested in others, investing in others, and listening to others. He's private, and yet he's a giver of his time and his effort to anybody else who needs it. He is very confident in his faith. His faith is dependent upon God for every single thing he does. You've heard him express it. His passion for God is strong, and he's interested in giving back to the kingdom. His impact on each of our lives, and mine particularly, is indelible. I have the incredible privilege and the honor to get to call him what most of you don't, Father. You may call him Pops, but I get to call him Father, and it is a privilege. Lonnie Rowland has given to me the most amazing lifetime of scripts. He's given me the life and the love of Jesus Christ, and nothing ever could have been better. Thank you, Pops.
Thank you, son.
I love you.
I like you, son. I love this church and I love this people, but I like to attend all three services because I like to meet the people. For if you go to one service, you don't see the rest of them. You don't meet them. So I love the church and the people. Thank you.
Thanks, Dad. Get your award right there.
The Oscar for Lifetime Achievement goes to Lonnie Rowland.
Thank you.
Corinthians 12, 4 through 8 says, love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things.
John 13, 34 and 35, a new commandment I give to you, that you love one another just as I have loved you. And that you also are to love one another. And by all this, you will know that people will know that you are my disciples if you have love for one another. Ephesians 4, 2, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love. And the fruit of the Spirit award for love goes to Lonnie Rowland.
Dylan, what a fun time we've had this morning.
Fun time it was. Yeah.
Yeah.
But I would like to, it's really been great, guys, and I really want to start to thank a couple people. Anyways, Pastor Tim last week was talking about a certain couple things, and what I took out of it was that great sex makes great kids. So, Dad, thank you.
What? Dylan. Seriously.
Just look at it. You get all this.
Dylan,
it's
seriously.
A deal.
Come on.
I just thought
bring
that.
Bring up
since,
last week's sermon?
I just thought that since last week she got her little fame, I wanted to take mine. You know? You got the most important guy standing right here. But it's all good. It's all good. My parents know I love them. But truly, we do. we do want to really thank the pastors because I do hope, after all the joking, that they do know that we really do love them and greatly appreciate them allowing us to be up here. Because they sacrifice so much of their time and the kingdom of God.
So let's invite Bob back to sing our final number. What a great day this was honoring our pastors here at New Hope. Before we turn this over to Pastor Tim, let me offer a prayer. Lord Jesus, thank you for the opportunity to gather and worship you. Thank you for choosing these men to be our pastors and to serve your children here. I thank you for their surrender to you, and in that we've been able to see you through them, and I thank you for that. I pray that today would bless you and glorify you, and I pray that you would bless our pastors and their families as they continue to serve and minister to people, and just pray that you would refresh them and bless them, and again, I thank you for them and their families. In Jesus' name, amen.
And with that, Corey and I would like to
say
thank you.
Just say thank you.
I don't want to see you go.
Thank you.
We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Dylan is our latest intern. Robert, you could have made your first major mistake. Oh, it's great fun. Thank you all so very much for being here. You've just highlighted the pastors, but please know there are there's a great number of other folks who make what you think we do possible. There's an incredible staff around here that we are blessed with, and we say thanks to all of them. Pastor Evie Hill was talking about racial violence in downtown Watts in the Los Angeles area. Evie Hill was a Baptist preacher. He was in the midst of all of that tension at that particular time. There was another one of the black pastors who had already been killed because of his involvement in that racial tension. Evie Hill got a threatening phone call one day, and he was told that if he did not cease his involvement in the racial conflict resolution, that he would be killed. They told him they would put a bomb in his car, and they would never know when. The next morning when he woke up, he noticed that his wife was not in bed with him. When he looked around the house, he couldn't find her, and he went out to the garage, and he noticed their car was gone. He looked out the window, and he saw his wife driving up in the car in the driveway, and when he asked her what was she doing, she said, "I just wanted to be sure there wasn't a bomb that would explode on you." He said he never had to question her love for Christ or his love for him. It's that kind of commitment and love that inspires somebody to take risks in their life. That's the Christian model that was set for us by Jesus Christ himself, the giving of his very life. I don't know that any of our pastors' wives have had to drive cars with potential bombs in them. But each one of us men have been blessed with God-influenced women who love and care for Christ with all their hearts and who care for their husbands. Regina, I've known you since you were a little girl. Your faith roots go deep. And that faith has been tried in the pressure of severe trials in your life. Your faithfulness to Christ, to your family, to New Hope, incredibly appreciated. I know that your life is anchored in Jesus, and there's not a laughter that is more contagious anywhere on the premises than yours. And I want to thank you for sharing your husband and for sharing your home for the kingdom work and for the gifts of ministry that you express here at New Hope. Thank you. Thank you very much. Jerry, a good Montana woman from strong Mennonite stock was exactly what Jean Sperling from Delano, California needed. When Jean wanted to leave a successful insurance business and pursue ministry, you didn't treat that as a midlife crisis. You treated that as a midlife course adjustment that you knew was influenced by Jesus Christ. You share with him a passion for people. Your sense of humor gives life a very healthy perspective. Your givingness and your caring spirit reflects brightly your passion for Christ. And for all of you, I want you to be praying for Jerry this week, particularly on Wednesday. She goes in for a heart ablation. So please be praying for her as they try to get her heart to beat regularly all the time, rather than just some of the time. Angelina, you are the newest pastor's wife to the staff here at New Hope. We want to thank you for putting a spring back in Gil's step and a smile that never leaves his face. We loved Thelma and the reflection of Christ that she gave in her work here at New Hope. And because you love Gil, you've made it easy for us to love you too. Though we don't speak fluently the same language, you do speak fluently the language of Christ's love for his word and for other people. Your compassion for others is obviously evident in your actions and in your grace-filled expressions. Angelina, You are a perfect gift for Gil in this season of life, and we love you for it. Melissa, the one with gentleness. You and Robert have grown up together, literally. And you have been very good for each other. Your tender heart for children, your passion for learning, you have been a wonderful partner for Robert. You two reflect partnership in so much of what you do. I want to thank you for your willingness to sacrifice time and energy and resources to walk right along with Robert in the calling of family, in the ministry, and in the kingdom's work. Thank you for sharing life together with Robert. The two of you give an example that's important for all of our kids to see and to watch and to learn from. So thank you very, very much. I was told not to say anything about the pastor's wife. And though she has been in control of most of what went on today, she's not in control of this. My grandmother was a pastor's wife. My mother was a pastor's wife. I am now married to a pastor's wife. I believe I can say I've been significantly influenced by pastors' wives all of my life. And Shelley, I did my very best to warn you and maybe even to scare you about what life to a pastor could be like. You flinched, but you did not run. These past 6 years have been absolutely amazing. You discovered that what I warned you about was not an exaggeration at all. Life in a fishbowl has its trials and its moments. Though you flinched on occasions, you have been faithful and you have been fearless. You were strong-willed, which is a survival technique necessity for being married to me. But what I really deeply love is that you want to be shaped and molded by Christ, and you give him permission to do that to you, even when it hurts. Your love for women behind bars, where you can share your own story of abuse, is incredible. Your passion for young girls that you want to grow up to be godly young women and not face some of the horrors that you faced is indescribable for me. Your sacrificial love for me and for my own family, words do not describe my appreciation. Your desire to give more of our collective resources to God's kingdom work is always exciting, and your hunger to learn and help others grow in faith. These are just a drop in the ocean of reasons of why I love you and I enjoy sharing life with you. Chuck Swindoll said the word to rally means to muster for a common purpose, to be aroused for action, to come together with a renewal of effort. I pray that our joint life in Christ is a rallying point for every one of us. From pastoral staff, to spouses, to congregation, I hope all of us will realize that our life in Christ is a rallying point for us all to share this incredible gift of eternal life, of everlasting life, with others that are around us. I trust we will give him permission to express himself through us personally as well as us collectively so that others will be drawn to him. Let me clarify. I did not say great sex makes great kids. I needed to clarify that for our visitors today who weren't here last week and would walk out of here thinking that this is a really weird church. I may not be able to dispel the weird part, but we did talk about sex. We talked about holy sex. We did talk about God's plan for sex. and that's enough said on that. I just wanted to point that out. Let me wrap this up. Father, thank you. Thank you for the surprises you bring to our life. Thank you for the ways in which you teach us humility, which none of us like those lessons, but we need them badly. Thank you for the way in which you want to demonstrate your life through us and through this fellowship. In the name of Christ, we pray. Amen.